Three new riders joined Terry and I in Astana. Baz and Linda from Holland, and Rod, a Scotsman from London. The new guys' bikes were shipped to Astana on the back of a trailer and were a few days late. So while we waited, I fitted an Osco chain oiler and a new rear brake caliper.
What you got there, Terry?
They're yours, mate.
Hey?
They're yours, mate.
They do look like mine. They look like the good ones.
Rod was on a 2008 KTM 690 with rally raid kit. Baz was on a heavily modified BMW Airhead, and Linda on a tricked up BMW G650X Country.
Okay, the four BMWs and one KTM have set off on from Astana. On our way to Mongolia, and it's really, really hot. We've not got very far when it looks like the KTM behind me has broken down already. I think we've done about, 300 yards. What's happened?
Absolutely, look, it's not getting fuel. Absolutely. It's never fell off. It died on the way in. I'm not sure. The bottom tank, that's been closed. And the bottom tank's empty.
So it's the pump. It just sometimes works and sometimes doesn't. I think he's just right on the corner, isn't he?
Yeah. How's your day been so far, Rod?
I never swear on camera, Walter. You'll find that about me. It's been less than marvellous, thank you very much. But it's getting better, we hope, by the moment. Me, I'm in a rock and roll band. Riding in a Stutz
Bearcat gym. Those were different times. Is it still firm, the pressure in the line?
Rules of I think the exhaust should be tight.
You're absolutely right.
Right, it's been a bit of an eventful first day on the road. We rode about 500 yards down the road and Rod's KTM died. But Rod and Baz have been working pretty hard over the last hour or so in the shade, and it's 35 degrees here today. They seem to have found the problem, which was a kink in the in a hose actually inside the fuel tank. Terry, I just can't drag him away from the jacuzzi. I think he's got to realise that the party's finished now and it's time to do some riding.
I'm very disappointed.
Terry, how are you, mate? Sorry to drag you out of the jacuzzi like that.
I'm not happy, man. I want to stay another month.
We weren't going anywhere that night. Rod and Baz continued working on the KTM till late into the night, while Terry, Linda and I chilled out on the beach.
Well, it's the morning after now, and Rod and Baz have been up till 11 o'clock, after 11 o'clock last night, working on the bike. And it looks like Rod's bike, the problem was the fuel filter, we hope. We've changed a whole bunch of parts, but then unkinked a few hoses, but that seems to be the thing that's actually made some difference. So let's hope it gets us through the day today.
Let's hear the sound of action.
Nothing.
All good.
They're just getting some money out in Astana. The funky new town, it's all pretty modern and high tech here, high rise glass buildings. Terry Brown has some new glasses that she picked up from the market for 5 or 6 quid. He feels very, very happy with them. Protect his eyes, improve his eyesight, and boy, does he look cool.
Кто первый поехал перед тобой? Куда едете?
Магадан.
Магадан?
Из Англии.
Из Англии.
Да, да.
Сначала Монголия, потом.
Да, потом Сибирь, Магадан. Да.
We didn't like our left turn.
Мост. Мост.
Да.
Первый, кто проехал, он нормально успел он. Вы успели,
да, когда
он
горел.
Да. Как зовут вас?
Уолтер.
Уолтер?
Да. Можно еще вариант, как все будет?
Уолтер, сейчас, минутку.
So I think he's going to go on the radio and talk to his the operators and find out what to do. We are free to go.
We couldn't wait to get out of Astana and get away from being hassled by the traffic police. We soon found a highway cafe and had lunch before turning on the dirt tracks. This would be the first taste of the dirt trail for our three new team members, and it began immediately with a huge water crossing. I plunged in first like a gung-ho cowboy and ended up drawing water into my fuel via the breather on the rear tank cap. This ended up flattening my battery, pumping the water out of the fuel tank and getting the bike going again. The others began their own survey to find the shallowest route across. Eventually they took the plunge, but still managed to find some deeper water.
Rod Curry.
Morning.
Now you're a man many would describe as the finest adventure motorcyclist in the world today. How did you find your first day yesterday on the...
Well, first let me say that it's not without reason that I might be described thus. I'll give you the benefit of my experience now, but, and you all need to listen about this. Yesterday was quite a tough day. We had quite a late start because one of us got a bike wet through, and then we flattened our battery trying to get it going. But with a good late day, we managed to get here last night and get eaten alive by midges. So all in all, the tracks were pretty easy. Nothing too technical, just a bit of slippery stuff. And yeah, we can live with that.